Tonight, we are going inside your health. We're taking a look at a connection between how many sports and energy drinks you consume and soda, cigarettes, and video games. Almost 2,800 teens in 20 public and middle schools and high schools in the Twin Cities took part in this study during the 2009-2010 school year. Researchers found more than 14% consumed energy drinks at least once a week. So KSTP medical expert Dr. Arkel Giorgio is in here to discuss some of this. We've got some of these examples, energy drinks like Rockstar and sports drinks like Gatorade. And what they're finding is that teenagers, kids who drink these are more likely to have some other bad habits.
That's right. What they found, like you said earlier, is that 14% of teens have energy drinks at least once a week, and 40% of those same students have these sports drinks. And the reason that that's a concern is that these behaviors are linked to other not so great behaviors like smoking and drinking. So specifically with energy drinks, which is probably the bigger concern, students who have energy drinks at least once a week are 2 to 3 times more likely to smoke cigarettes, and they're also more likely to drink alcohol, in addition to drinking sugary sweetened beverages, as well as playing much more video games.
Interesting. Now these drinks, they're marketed a lot of time as being healthy drinks. They'll give you a boost of energy, but they've got vitamins and minerals in them. What do you think about all that?
And calories and sugar and caffeine. Mm-hmm. And so what the American Academy of Pediatrics says, which of course is the governing organization, says that, you know, these sports drinks, you know, this bottle of Gatorade has about 250 calories in it. And not a lot of other nutrition.
Right.
And so what they say is that the better fluid, even if you've been exercising, is water. Really limit this to if you've been exercising. Energy drinks have no place in teens and youth.
Right, okay. Energy drinks, just skip them, limit these. But let's discuss a little bit more about what parents can do. Should you be concerned if you see your children drinking energy drinks?
Well, I think it's important to point out that energy drinks and sports drinks do not cause drinking alcohol, smoking cigarettes, playing video games. But what this study found is that there's a clustering of those behaviors. So here's what parents can do. If they see their kids consuming these sorts of beverages, it means that those other behaviors may not be so far behind. And so just take a moment to look a little bit more closely and see if those other behaviors are hiding somewhere.
Real quickly, we've got energy bars out here too. Is this something that comes into play as well?
Well, energy bars were not studied in this research study at the university. All of these came from my pantry.
Oh, goodness.
I'm almost embarrassed to say. Here's the bottom line on energy bars and cereal bars. We all like them because they're so darn convenient. But I think the bottom line message is make sure that they're going to give you at least some nutrition. Cereal bars, probably not your best option. Look for those with at least 3 to 5 grams of fiber, less than 200 calories, and at least 5 grams of protein. Then you're getting a little bit of nutrition with it.
All right, keeping us healthy tonight.
Trying.
Thank you, Doctor.
We appreciate it.
Well, if you have any other questions for Dr. Arkel Giorgio, she is headed back to our newsroom right now, and she's going to be answering your questions throughout the evening on our KSTP Facebook page. She'll be there till 11 o'clock.